A CNN investigation now. In the early days of the pandemic, back in February 2020, members of Congress got closed-door briefings on the situation. Then came some serious questions. Namely, did some lawmakers profit from their knowledge of the pending COVID crisis and sell stocks to make money? The lawmakers deny wrongdoing. A Justice Department investigation brought no criminal charges. The stock trades by Republican Senator Richard Burr are still being investigated by the Securities and Exchange Commission. CNN senior investigative correspondent Drew Griffin caught up with Senator Burr on Capitol Hill. Here's his report.
North Carolina Senator Richard Burr in a Senate office building last week had no interest in talking about his perfectly timed stock sales.
Senator Burr?
Yeah.
Drew Griffin with CNN. We wanted to ask you about those stock trades back in February of 2020. You know, the SEC says that you had material, non-public information when you made those trades.
You have to look at what I put out.
I did look at what you put out. How is that not insider trading?
What he put out in March of 2020 was his explanation for why he sold off more than $1.6 million in stocks weeks before the pandemic market crash. He claims he made the trades relying solely on public news reports. But the Securities Exchange Commission isn't so sure, and in October publicly released details of an investigation of the senator and his politically connected brother-in-law for insider trading. According to the SEC, in early 2020, Burr was getting confidential briefings about the severity of the coronavirus in his positions on Senate Intelligence and Health Committees. According to a memo from attorneys for the SEC, on February 13, 2020, Senator Burr possessed material non-public information concerning COVID-19 and its potential impact on the U.S. and global economies when he called his own stockbroker at 8:54 a.m., directing the sale of $1.65 million in stock, virtually all the stocks he owned. At 11:32 a.m. that same morning, Burr then called his brother-in-law, Gerald Foth, a Trump appointee to the National Mediation Board. The two men talked for just 50 seconds. The SEC claims Foth hung up and immediately called two stockbrokers directing the sale of several stocks in his wife's account, though his lawyer said in a court filing that he had planned his trades days in advance and initiated the trades with his broker the day before his call with Burr. A week later, the stock market began to crash.
True carnage. This was a disastrous day.
$1.6 million stocks you've got, and you don't warn the rest of the public. You didn't warn your constituents in North Carolina.
You're focusing on ratings.
You warned your brother.
You're the lowest in media. And maybe this is a great example of why.
If that's not insider trading, is it at least immoral?
And while Burr was quietly selling off his stocks just a week earlier, he had co-authored an op-ed claiming the United States today is better prepared than ever before to face emerging public health threats like the coronavirus. Trevor Potter is with the Campaign Legal Center, a government watchdog.
The news here is that there's a live investigation going on. They have laid out their timeline of what they think happens, and they could well bring charges. We don't know yet.
Burr is one of at least four U.S. senators whose pre-pandemic stock sales were under criminal investigation by the Department of Justice. Those criminal cases have all been closed with no charges. But the SEC said in November its civil investigation against Burr, which could result in fines, was continuing, though the SEC will now not comment on the case. Burr has stepped down from his chairmanship of Senate Intelligence. He'd already announced his retirement. His brother-in-law has denied wrongdoing, but President Biden dropped his renomination to the National Mediation Board. Potter, with the Campaign Legal Center, says legal or not, politicians profiting off trading stocks is a part of a bigger problem.
They're getting rich up here. By and large, people that are elected to office and come to this town seem to leave with a lot more money than they came.
Well, again, that really causes Americans to wonder what's going on and to be suspicious about whether members are feathering their own nest with insider information. They may or may not be, but the fact that somebody is making a killing in the market is going to cause people to wonder where that information came from.
There are two Senate bills seeking to end that suspicion. Both would ban members of Congress from buying and selling stocks while in office.
I call this hearing to order.
Trevor Potter says don't expect either one to get much legislative attention.
Members of Congress never want to put restraints on themselves.
In fact, just last month, Speaker Nancy Pelosi, one of the richest members of Congress, seemed to shoot down any idea of a stock trade ban for members.
Because this is a free market and people, we have a free market economy, they should be able to participate in that.
But it is Richard Burr's seemingly perfectly timed pre-pandemic stock trades that have raised the most attention from regulators.
How is that not insider trading?
And Drew Griffin joins us now. Senator Burr didn't seem very concerned, obviously. Even if it's not illegal, is the Senate worried that this looks like insider trading?
You know, look at his actions. Burr actually asked the Senate Ethics Committee to investigate him, Anderson, probably knowing that those internal investigations in the Senate often, in fact, almost always, go nowhere. A spokesperson for the chair of that committee today wouldn't even comment on if there is or ever was an investigation on Burr's stock trades in the Senate. It's part of a bigger problem on Capitol Hill, say critics. These elected officials get rich. There's little to no oversight on how or an explanation of why. And with Congress policing itself, you're almost guaranteed inaction. And that's no matter which party is in power.
Drew Griffin, appreciate it. Thanks.